castle is a designated special place. It's one of 81 special places in the province. And unfortunately, it's the only one of the 81 that hasn't received its final protective status yet. And we don't believe that there should be any logging in a protected area. We really have to ask the Department of Sustainable Resource Development if they're going to start logging in other protected areas or parks. Is the Whaleback going to be next? Is it going to be a provincial park? Is it going to be Waterton Lakes National Park? If they can log in this protected area, are they going to be wanting to log in others? The castle is a premier recreational area. A lot of people from this area recreate here. It's considered prime grizzly bear habitat for the Grizzly Bear Recovery Program. And it's one of the main water towers for southern Alberta. There are a lot of really important things about the castle and are good reasons not to be logging here. It doesn't really seem to matter to SRD. It doesn't seem to be an issue. Opinion polls show that more than 75% of the local residents from the Crow's Nest Pass to Lethbridge are opposed to clear-cut logging in the castle. We know that tens of thousands of electronic messages have gone into the government. Hundreds of letters and phone calls have gone in opposing this logging. We have had five other rallies similar to this one. We've met with MLAs, we've met with various ministers, various staff people. It doesn't seem to have really helped so far. And we really have to ask, what more can the public do to get our message across? It's really hard to see how Spray Lakes can be making any money here. This is often called a matchstick forest. These trees are, most of them are quite small. Only about 60% of them could be turned into dimensional lumber, and about 40% will be turned into fence posts or garden mulch. So here we are cutting down a protected area in order to make to make garden mulch. It just doesn't make sense. It's a 6.5 hour return trip to their mill in Cochrane, and it really is hard to understand with the price of diesel, with that long of a haul, with these small little trees, how people can how they can be making any money. And we really have to ask why Spray Lakes is starting to cut here in the first place. This is a contentious area. It's supposed to be a protected place. Spray Lakes has other areas that they could be cutting in that they could have started in before this. It really is hard to understand why they would start here. And it's almost like Spray Lakes and Sustainable Resource Development are poking their finger in the eye of the public. It really is hard to understand why they would start here. Perhaps they are poking their finger in our eye, or perhaps they think that the writing is on the wall for logging in the castle and they want to high grade what they can out of here as soon as possible before it's too late. In her New Year's message, and I want to read this off the paper just so I get it correct, Premier Redford said, "This is your government and your opinions matter. That is a big part of the change agenda, to continue with dialogue with Albertans on issues that matter to them. Premier Redford, this matters very much to us. Please stop this unwanted and ill-considered logging before it's too late."
My name is Mike Judd. I'm a resident of this area, a lifetime resident. I've spent my lifetime as an outfitter and a dog sled musher here, bringing people to this part of the castle to appreciate the wilderness. People from all over the world have come and expressed what a wonderful place this is. And the integral part of it, what makes it so wonderful, is the wonderful forest that we have. And through my lifetime, what I've seen is a continual erosion of the wilderness, of the forest, with clear-cut logging starting at the very headwaters of these beautiful valleys and progressing down to the point where we're at today. This is the landscape of the grizzly bear, and logging and grizzly bears do not mix. Grizzlies are always the losers when logging occurs, because with logging comes roading, which cannot be controlled, and with the roads come increased human activity. Science has proven this over and over again. The amount of roads, industrial roads, that we already have in this country is almost twice the acceptable scientific level threshold for grizzly bears to survive. The grizzly bear, as you know, is already on the endangered list in Alberta, which means that instead of the province paying just lip service to protecting the grizzly bear, it really has to start doing real things on the ground. And this project is totally contrary to that. Everything that this project will bring with it is detrimental to the future of the grizzly bear here. So that is one of my biggest concerns. There are many other wild animals. Elk populations are very low, partly because they need big secure habitat to survive. And this core in this area, the castle here, is the last of that habitat. So I'm here today on behalf of my family and hopefully my grandchildren to ensure that they will have a forest, they will have wildlife to look at, they will have clean water, and that they will be able to enjoy all of the wild recreation that I have through all my lifetime.
My name is Peter Sherrington. I'm a full-time resident of Beaver Mines. I'm a bit of a Johnny come lately down here. I've only lived here for 4 years, and I actually moved to the area to study the wildlife here. I've been doing that over the last 4 years, and I've lived and worked in many, many parts of Canada, and this is one of the most fascinating places I've ever been. The biodiversity here is amazing, and we're still finding out new things. I'm continuously surprised here. So the other thing I'm surprised about is that we are here today still lobbying for the castle to be protected. And, way back in about 93, the Alberta Conservation Board recommended that this be preserved as a wilderness park. Under the government's special places program of the late 90s, this was accepted as a special place. Now, every other place that was accepted has been legislated as protected. The castle hasn't. This is the water tower for the whole of the prairies. Water has become a very important political issue. I mean, we now have water as a specific part of the Ministry of the Environment. And yet water has been talked to about right from the beginning. It's actually inherent in the Public Lands Act. It's inherent in the Forestry Protection Act. Forestry management is not logging. It's to protect for water, it's to protect for recreation, it's to protect for wildlife. And logging is detrimental to that. This area here, under a normal fire cycle, should produce about 42% old growth forest, that is forest over 100 years old. In the castle, we have less than 10%. And trees are essential for collecting the snow for the water. We have an obligation to pass that water on to Saskatchewan, to pass it on to Manitoba. And yet we are destroying or degrading this for very short term, and probably not even monetary gain. Recreation is important here. We have a very thin forest cover here relative to BC. This is where people come for their recreation. This would be the perfect adjunct to both Waterton Glacier National Park, the Peace Park, and also to the now preserved Flathead under a memorandum of understanding between Montana and British Columbia. This is the hole in the system. Mm-hmm. So we also have international responsibilities here. This isn't just a local issue. This is a provincial and an international issue. Logging does not control fires. It doesn't prevent fires. In fact, it may even encourage it. And then there was the pine beetle. You have to log all the trees because of the pine beetle. In fact, it's forest management practices over the last 100 years, fire suppression, single stand, low diversity forests that have created a smorgasbord for pine beetles. So again, logging hasn't solved the problem. Cold winters solved the problem. The forest management practices have actually created the problem. They've created an absolute perfect storm for pine beetles. So we just keep getting different stories. So if it's not economic, what is it? Why are they?
I'm Rebecca Holland. I live in Beaver Mines. I run the Beaver Mines General Store. I moved here because of what you see around you. And so when I heard that there was a good chance that it would be torn down and destroyed, I had to ask why. And as I asked why, and I got answers back from the government that didn't seem to jive with any of the research that has been done, I felt duped. And as I continued to ask why beyond that, I felt ignored. I also think that the government is playing a couple of different roles here. One is where they're coming in and taking down the trees and destroying this beauty, but there's another whole arm of the government that is spending lots of money and encouraging the world to come to travel Alberta. And when you see pictures on the ads, what do you see? You see people playing in the mountains, and they're saying, just breathe. Well, I'd like to breathe here, and I would like to invite other people to breathe here, but they're going to have some trees in order to come here and do their breathing. So I think that the government needs to decide which way they're going to go on this. And I believe strongly that no matter what scale you use in terms of putting a value to the trees, whether you're looking at it economically, environmentally, or to do with tourism and recreation, any scale will show you that the trees have much more value standing up where they are than being removed and turned into mulch. What I'd really like is to invite Premier Redford to use this issue as a good news story for Alberta. We need to clear up our rather dark name internationally in the environmental scene and say, okay, this will be my legacy. I will leave the beauty of Southwest Alberta as is. Thank you.
The castle logging should not happen because we have a 20-kilometer width band of forest here and 2,000 kilometers of prairie east of us, no trees, and 1,000 kilometers west of us in BC, loaded with trees. Everybody in Alberta wants to come and play in our 20-kilometer width of trees. The animals are trying to survive here. The campers want to come and see wildlife. The fishermen want to come and fish here. And yet the loggers are trying to log this place that is very delicate, very primitive land, 1.3 kilometers above sea level, and it takes 100 years for one tree to mature, compared to about 40 years in BC. And these so-called experts of forestry engineers should really be working in BC.
So another point in this whole issue is that apparently there was a consultation with the local population on the logging issue long before this even started to be moved into concrete plans. I've lived here for over 30 years. I've never heard anything about this consultation. And if there was one, I asked to have access to the information, which was not even, the request was not even answered. I would have liked to look at it to see what is really the basis of some of these decisions that were made to say we had really a local consultation on that issue.